Are your PlayStation 2 games lagging on the PowKid X28 portable console? Not sure how to set up the emulator or which one to choose? Watch this video till the end and you'll be able to play awesome games like Need for Speed Most Wanted, GTA San Andreas, Batman, X-Men Legends, Splinter Cell, and more. This is another helpful video for handheld console lovers, especially those who enjoy playing PlayStation 2 games. Today, I'll walk you through some of the best graphic settings for the EtherSX 2 emulator on the PowKid X28, which will make your gaming experience even smoother. By the way, you can also use these settings if you're playing on an Android phone or tablet with a weaker processor. But first, let's talk about which version of the emulator you should install. To run PlayStation 2 games on X28 console running Android 11, I use the EtherSX2 emulator, which is a fast open-source emulator based on PCSX2. After trying different versions, I found that version 3.6.6.8 works best for my console, but if you have a newer version of Android, you can try a more recent build. By the way, check out my Telegram channel. I recently posted how to install the PS2 emulator there. You'll find the link in the description box. Once you've installed the emulator on your PowKid X28 or any other Android device and noticed that many games run poorly, lag, or have low FPS, I recommend tweaking the graphic settings. So, let's go into the menu and select Up Settings at the bottom of the list. Then, go to the Graphics tab. The main change I recommend is setting the GPU render to Vulkan. For me, OpenGL and software modes just didn't provide the performance I needed. I set the upscale multiplier to 1x native because increasing it leads to more lag in games. Tweaking the other settings didn't make much of a difference, so I left them as they were. If you scroll down a bit, you'll find another important setting – threaded presentation. If you have a mild GPU like me, make sure this is enabled. The rest of the settings in this tab should match mine as well. Now let's go to the System tab. The two most important settings here are Cycle Rate and Cycle Skip. For more demanding games, I suggest increasing cycle skip first, then lowering the cycle rate until you find the best performance. I found that a 75% cycle rate and moderate underclock for cycle skip gave me the best results in most games I tested. You can copy the rest of the settings here as well. Next, let's move on to the Audio tab. Since games might be skipping frames, you could notice some audio lag. To fix this, I recommend setting the synchronization mode to async mix, and I didn't change any other settings here. Finally, head to the Advanced tab and make sure that the first four settings are enabled. You can also compare the rest with my setup. Now, back to the main screen, and let's head into the menu again. This time, go to Controller Settings and then Touchscreen. If you're set up the emulator on the PowKid X28, you should disable Touchscreen Controller View. To enable vibration during gameplay, I suggest turning on both Vibrate on Press and Enable Game Vibration. This will enhance your gaming experience. Next is the Controller Port 1 tab. Here, we need to select DualShock 2 as the controller type and assign all the buttons. First, set up the D-pad by matching each direction clockwise, starting with Up. Then do the same for the Triangle, Circle, Cross, and Square buttons. Next, assign the Select and Start buttons, followed by L1, L2 and R1, R2. To set L3 and R3, press down on the left and right analog sticks. We'll skip analog toggle and apply pressure and move on to setting up the left analog stick clockwise and then the right analog stick the same way. I also recommend adjusting the analog sensitivity setting, which you will find further down in the menu. I understand this setting is personal, so I suggest remembering its location and tweaking it during gameplay for better precision. I set mine to 133%. By the way, here you can also invert the controls if needed. Use this option if you can't change the controls in the game options. And before we continue, please like and subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. This helps me promote the channel. Also, you can click the bell icon so you don't miss any new videos. Thank you for your attention. Let's continue. So, with the main settings down, let's test some games. This Batman game runs great. Smooth gameplay with no lags or freezes. The sound stutters occasionally, but it's nothing major, and the game is totally playable. Another Batman game also performs excellently. Smooth, no lags or freezes, and crisp gameplay. GTA San Andreas lags a bit at the start, but once the map and world loading, it becomes much more playable. The graphics aren't perfect, but it's still playable with minimal freezes. Now let's test the Need for Speed series. Hot Pursuit 2 feels much smoother, I like it. Moreover, even Most Wanted runs well. The game doesn't lag or freeze, even during slow motion or boost moments. The FPS in Underground also surprised me in a good way. It's much more playable now, with no lags or freezes, and I'm excited to play through it again. The Hawk game also performs great, with smooth gameplay. As you can see, some games run perfectly, with no lags or freezes. In those cases, you can even try improving the emulator settings. You can do this on your own, and let me know how your tweaks work out in the comments. Here is my favorite game, Splinter Cell: Pandora Tomorrow. The gameplay is very smooth, with no lags or freezes, and I've already completed it on my PowKid X28. I'm currently going through the first part. I also tested Shadow of the Colossus, which is a pretty demanding game for this console. Even with optimized settings, it lags, so the gameplay isn't very smooth. Another game, Star Wars: The Force Unleashed, also feels a bit slow. It's not the best experience, but maybe with some extra tweaks, it'll improve. Finally, let's test Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 4. The graphics are nice and smooth, with no noticeable lags or freezes, and the game runs comfortably. If you're a fan of this series, you'll enjoy it. I hope this video helped you out, and now you can enjoy your favorite games with much better performance on the PowKid X28 or your Android device. Please like and subscribe to the channel. I wish you pleasant nostalgia and successful completion of your favorite games.